Martin and I met actually through mutual friends.
It actually took us a while to meet.
Initially, he had poked me on Facebook.
There's actually quite a few mutual friends between us.
We met at the bar and we hung out with friends.
I kept hearing about this girl from one of my close buddies, and there were so many events where I was supposed to see her and meet her, and it just never happened, and there was always something that came up.
The more we hung out, the more we liked each other, and eventually we started dating.
She's short.
When I first met Martin, he dressed and looked very differently than he does today.
But I loved it. Like, that's the first thing I noticed, and I loved it. And she had this great smile.
He was a little bit gangster, I shall say, and that intrigued me.
Just from right there, I kind of knew she was special, and yeah, I mean, it's funny, you don't really know someone that well, but yet we talked nonstop.
He had a soft heart, and he cared about his family, but he had a tough exterior, and I liked that about him. And I found, you know, that's what drew me towards him, and, you know, eventually that phase passed. I look forward to spending my life with him.
Her smile and just how happy she was, it was awesome.
Martin had planned to propose in Mexico.
It was kind of a group honeymoon.
After his sister's wedding, which was 2 years ago. Unfortunately, during our bridal prep for his sister, I heard his mom telling the hairdresser that he was going to propose next week, which kind of ruined things in the sense that his cousins were there and everybody kind of found out, and that spread like wildfire, of course. And so he decided that he wasn't going to propose. Me knowing that he left the ring at home and that he wasn't going to propose, we proceeded to Mexico, just had a relaxing vacation, the two of us. And to my surprise,
I decided to do it in the pool or while we were tanning. And I didn't have any pockets in my shorts, so I ended up holding this ring tight in my hand for a good hour, building up the courage to even go up, like, to say it to her. And so we went inside the swimming pool, and the funny thing is it was in shallow water, so, or somewhat shallow, and so I'm proposing to her. I'm on one knee.
At first I didn't realize that it was the proposal, so I laughed a little bit. But then when I realized that, you know, he was actually proposing, I said yes, of course, and here we are today.
She doesn't believe me. She didn't see that I was on one knee because we're in the water, right? So she kind of hesitated, not yes, no, but hesitated to see if I was even joking with her, because I think I might have made jokes before about it.
At first, I didn't realize that it was the proposal, so I laughed a little bit.
A few seconds later, she really knew it was serious, and you know, the voice starts cracking, and I mean, you have this long speech prepared of how everything, but it's amazing how 100 words turns into 10 so fast.
When I realized that, you know, he was actually proposing, I said yes, of course, and here we are today.
And I just told her how special she was and how I was certain she was the girl for the rest of my life, and just did it right there in the pool right next to the bartender. Actually, he was close by, but it was great. It was different. I don't know how many people propose in pools, but there it is. But I remember my hands were so sweaty from holding that ring so tight, so she wouldn't see it. But I don't even think she knows that. So